Hi, I'm Jyoti Mishra, and I'm a faculty at UCSF at a laboratory called the Cognitive Neuroscience Laboratory, and we study the brain here and how it controls behavior, your day-to-day behavior, and how it learns over time to get better at behavior, and how we can improve the brains of people who may have deficits in performance and behavior, yeah. Mostly parents. They're both physicians and academics to some extent. My mom's a big influence. She's sort of like my idol, and like my, she's like a working mom, and she's always loved teaching, and sometimes she used to translate very well what she taught to her medical students to me while I was still in school. And you know, she really encouraged me to read scientific articles, which didn't mean anything to me. They were all jargon, but then she'd, you know, go through it like a story and explain things. So yeah, that's what initially got me really curious about the process of science. Initially, it was by chance that I got into computational work, and then later it was just like this curiosity about cognition, and then trying to meld that with my initial skill set that I started learning with internships. And eventually it was only in my PhD that I got to do the work, this really linking behavior with what goes happens in the brain with these EEG recordings, electroencephalography. So electro means electrical, and cephalo means related to the brain, and graphy is basically, you know, you're graphing it, you're measuring it. So it measures the electrical activity in the brain, essentially. So it's like a cap. It's almost like a swim cap that you wear on your head, and we put 64 different electrodes on the head, which cover the entire head, pretty much all over the skull, to all the way to like 256 electrodes. The density can be greater and greater. Basically, the neurons or the nerve cells in the brain, they communicate with each other through electrical impulses, and these current flows, they don't happen in isolation in single neurons. They happen in populations of neurons, and sometimes, so I'd say with EEG, once there's like 10,000 or so neurons in a population firing together, which happens very consistently, we can measure that on top of the scalp. In a lot of the tests that I do, you know, the people would be looking at things, and they might be attending to something and being distracted by other things. And you're gonna discriminate the green circles from the red circles, always pressing the response button, which will be the space bar in your case, to the green circle. And then you can really measure in the brain then when something happened, a stimulus happened, where was their attention? Was it on the task? Was it off task? How good was their attention? There are many, many people who have deficient attention, and pretty much any person can improve on attention, but older adults have a problem with attending, especially with greater distractibility. Similar problems exist with the children with ADHD. So I've worked with both of those populations, generated tools essentially from our basic neuroscience understanding of how attention works, and then give these tools out to these people to see if they can improve their attention in any way. And we have found good outcomes in all of these studies. And people play these games like they're playing video games, essentially. So in some ways, it's we call them serious games. So they're not, you know, like the usual video games. So in some ways, it's rewarding, and because we're doing new things every day, and really feel like, you know, the projects are always what pretty much, like, I mean, it's cliche to say it, but it's mostly like what no one's ever done before. So it's exciting to get up every day and do that.